In this After Effects tutorial, we'll create this retro title animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll use a few shapes in combination with standard effects to spread some retro vibes. Alright, let's get started. First of all, we create a container for the title itself. We create a new comp. Let's name it title then. HD resolution, 3 seconds long. Transparent background for now. Then we use the title tool to add our title. I use Neue Color Black, which I think is very retro. Color black, size 175 pixels. The font is available on Adobe Fonts. We left align the text, align the text layer to the center using the alignment tool. Awesome. This makes sure we can change the text anytime later without having to recreate the whole animation. Then we add one more comp, which we name Animation. Black background here. First of all, we choose the ellipse tool and double click on it to add a new shape. Solid fill, color white, no stroke. Let's name it Spot White. We open the ellipse path property and check constraint proportions and set the size to 600 by 600 pixels. Then let's move it slightly up to Y475. We add the title comp, continuously rasterize it, then scale it up to 500%. Next, we position the first letter of the title in the white spot. With no layer selected, we use the rectangle tool to create a shape that covers the first letter. Fill white. Let's move it below to check it. Seems about right. And let's name it mask. We move it back up and use it as Luma Matte for the title comp. Here's the black spot, so let's quickly correct that. If you want the letter to be visible only within the white spot, you could add a set matte effect and use the track matte from the white spot shape. Nevertheless, we need to link the mask to the title comp using the pick width tool. Next, we set position keyframes at 20 frames for the title comp and the shape layer. At 12 frames, we move the shape layer further to the right and set another position keyframe for the title comp. At the beginning, we move the spot to the left, out of the screen, the title to the right, out of the screen. Then we select the position keyframes of the title comp. Open the graph editor to edit the speed graph. We slow down the beginning here, the end slightly. There's no movement in the second part. Then we select the position keyframes of the shape layer and slow down the beginning. Move the middle points down to the zero line and slow down the end quite a bit. Let's see. It's like a searchlight catching the letter by accident. Before adding a scribble effect, let's take a quick moment to check out an awesome animation course by Domestika. In this course, you'll learn how to create motion graphics, especially for social media. Express yourself online by creating animated stickers and GIFs. The process involves illustration and animation, from concept and sketch to animation in After Effects. And finally, just as important, publishing your GIFs. I've added the link to the course in the description. And even better, use the code MANUALDOESMOTION10 for an extra 10% off. Alright, let's add a scribble effect. We select the title comp, use the Effects and Presets window to add roughen edges. Border 4. Scale 30. Let's animate the evolution using a little expression. Time asterisk 500. Which changes the evolution 500 degrees per second. Next, we add wave warp. Set the wave height to 1, wave width 500. Then we animate the face, again with the time expression. Time asterisk 750 this time. We copy the two effects and add them to the shape layer. All right. Of course, the letter tries to hide in the dark. So at 32 frames, it runs off to the left, out of the screen. Let's open the ellipse path property of the shape layer and at 20 frames, we set a path size keyframe. Then at 32 frames, we scale it up so that it covers the whole screen. Let's move the letter completely out of the screen. Then we open the graph editor and slow down the beginning of the animation as much as possible. Make sure the points are on the zero line, not below. Awesome. Next, we add an adjustment layer to the top. Name it posterize time. And add posterize time. We set the frame rate to 8. That's why we use a mask layer, instead of just adding a mask to the title comp. Masks aren't affected by the posterize time effect. Finally, we add an echo effect to the shape layer. Echo time, -0.1. Number of echoes, 3. Decay, 0.5. Let's check it out. By the way, any idea which title intro inspired me to create this animation? It's a very famous movie series. Alright, let's add the second part. At 29 frames, we add the title comp again. Position it beyond the right edge. Add a keyframe. At 44 frames, we move it to the center, which is x960. If you wonder why it isn't in the center really, that's because of the posterize time effect. We slow down the end of the animation. Then we copy the roughen edges and wave warp effect and paste it to the new title comp. We need to shrink the border though, to 2. Scale to 20. And we reduce the wave height to 0.5, as well as the wave speed. We duplicate the spot white layer, move it up, press U to see all the keyframes, and delete them. Let's change the fill color to black, move the start point to 29 frames. And we reduce the size to 300 pixels. Set the Y position to 540 pixels. At 29 frames, we position it right, outside the screen. Add a keyframe. At 56 frames, we move it to the left, towards the beginning of the title. We open the graph editor and slow down the end of the animation. Next, we duplicate the title animation once more. Move it above the mask and add a fill effect to change the color to white. We want it only to be white within the black shape. So, like in the beginning of this tutorial, we add a set matte effect and take the matte from the spot black layer and set the source to effects and masks. Let's add an ending. At 63 frames, we set an ellipse path size keyframe. At the end, the shape covers the whole screen. We slow down the beginning of the animation as much as possible. Finally, we fade out the white title comp. Don't forget to check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys!